Plenty of young people in our region who are growing up very happily in beautiful rural isolation, but those advantages can pale as they start to get older.
In our latest update from Fixers, the campaign that helps young people make a difference, we hear from a young woman who wants to help teenagers in the Scottish Borders who, she says, can suffer loneliness, boredom and even depression.
When I was 9 or 10, roughly that age, I used to go on long walks along the railway, find Tarzan swings, play on them. Like a huge adventure every single day.
So this used to be my gang hut where we were allowed here. It's probably about 10 of us. It's good to come back here and look at these things, but like you can see it is sort of dead and gone.
My name's Charlotte Redpath. I live in Fountain Hall near Gallows Shields. I've lived here for 16 years in August, so I was 2 when I first moved here. It's difficult when you live here to go out and have fun because it's so far from anywhere that has an event on or an organisation. It's half an hour to Gallows Shields and an hour to Edinburgh. It can be really lonely. I think it helps that I've got a really close relationship with my dad, so I always have someone there. But he's not 18, so it's different.
It's really significant in the Borders with young people with being socially isolated. People can become very depressed, people can become very low in their mood, things such as self-harm can increase if somebody uses that as a coping strategy. I've seen people who have been very suicidal and have had a lot of suicidal thoughts.
It does get kind of lonely because Gallows, like, not that big a place. It's a hassle to meet my friends because they can live in, like, the other side of Gallows, so you've got to, like, walk for ages to meet them.
My Fixers project is to set up a magazine to help young people in the Borders feel less isolated. Fixers took me to a local newspaper to see a journalist.
A front page story this week is actually focusing on a new youth group that's been formed in Tweed Bank. Now Tweed Bank is quite close to Gallows Shields, and if youngsters are in Tweed Bank are feeling a bit isolated, then you can bet that youngsters further afield will feel likewise. What kind of magazine is it you're looking to put together?
It's going to be based on rural isolation, but also with issues like mental health, sexual health, physical health,
right.
And hopefully get like real life stories from people. I want young people coming up to this age to be able to experience what maybe I didn't. So I want them to be able to feel like they can go to activities and not have to worry about buses. I want them to know that there's activities there for them that they can go to and are accessible for them.